Welcome to Daily Dose Radio, a 5-minute devotional podcast studying the Psalms verse by verse. Broadcast from the ever beautiful Sharonville, Ohio, on the sunny side of Cincinnati. Hey, welcome back to Daily Dose Radio, the finest Bible bistro on the internet. Fresh, handled responsibly, chosen for you daily. This is Daily Dose Radio. Today we're in Psalm 127, and we're going to do verse 1 today. This is 5 verses long, and we have a superscript here that tells us that this is a song for those ascending, and it's by Solomon, so it's of Solomon, and we have some evidence, perhaps, in this psalm to suggest that it is of Solomon, and we'll begin with verse 1 today. Some of your ancient manuscripts will have verse 1 divided in half. Verse 1 would easily divide in half, logically, because you have the same opening in verse 1 as you would have in verse 2 if you divided the psalm right in half. So we begin with, if the Lord does not build the house, those who labor do so in vain who build it. Or we should say, those who labor lose their labor who build it. That idea of losing or in vain is those, either one of those could be a good translation for that word. Then we have it again in the second half of verse 1. If the Lord does not keep the city, those who watch in vain or lose their effort. We could say that as well. So that's verse 1. It's a song for those ascending by Solomon. And we begin with, if the Lord does not build the house. So what house are we talking about? Well, remember that this is an ascent psalm. And where are they headed? They're headed for Jerusalem. They're headed for that temple. This is the 8th step. So they could be standing on the steps leading up to the temple. So they're focused now on their destination. The house is the house of the Lord. And of course, this then would suggest perhaps that Solomon is the one who wrote it, because in the time of the creation of his temple, he would, and I'm sure that he could testify if he were here, and the scripture testifies on his behalf, that he wanted nothing more than this to be the house that the Lord built. But this also teaches us a lesson, that if the Lord is not in the thing that we're trying to do, then really, why are we doing it? Why are we striving after it? If the Lord does not build the house, then we are laboring and losing our labor in the building of it. If the Lord doesn't keep the city, well, then why watch? Why stand guard at the gate if the Lord's not going to keep it? So that's the idea here. He's the impetus. It is His Spirit that gives us the strength. It is His will that gives us the idea. It is His hand that causes it to prosper. So if He's behind it, then it will be blessed and it will grow. If He's not behind it, just take, for example, the building of the Tower of Babel. They wanted to build to reach the heavens, and they started to build, but the Lord wasn't in it. And what happened to the Tower of Babel? Well, it came crashing down. And so do all things come crashing down that men build. Eventually, they will be erased, and you won't be able to find them any longer, because they were created by the will of man, not by the will of God. But things that God created last, such as the earth. The earth is lasting because He's the one that created it. Such as the heavens, it is lasting because He created it. Such as Jerusalem, it is blessed because He has put His name there. You see, all of these things, we see God's hand behind. And for us in the church, I think we can say too, if the Lord is not in the thing, if He's not in the sermon, if He's not in the mission activity, if His hand does not bless our effort, then we labor in vain. So it's very important for us to make sure that the Lord is in the labor before we expend labor on a thing that He's not for. We must know His will. So this is a song for those ascending by Solomon. If the Lord is not building the house, if the Lord is not keeping the city, then vanity is what follows. I hope you'll join me tomorrow. We're going to look at verse 2 and maybe find a little more evidence for Solomon's hand in this. So find me then on Daily Dose Radio. Thanks for listening to Daily Dose Radio. I'm David Smith. The music today has been performed by the Bluegrass Experiment. Thanks again for listening. I'll see you next time on Daily Dose Radio.